Consider one example on Norton's theorem. Find current I using Norton's theorem. This is the given circuit. Here this is I. That is, I is the current through 5 ohm resistor that we supposed to calculate. First I will show the Norton's equivalent circuit. The Norton's equivalent circuit looks like this. That is, there is a current source which is known as IN. That is nothing but Norton's current, or sometimes it is also known as short circuit current ISC. Parallel to this, there is a resistor known as Norton's resistor, represented as RN. To these terminals, we supposed to connect the resistor in which we are finding current. Before that, first we'll calculate IN and RN. IN or ISC is a short circuit current which is obtained by removing the resistor in which branch the current is finding. So here we are finding the current in 5 ohm resistor. Let this is terminal A and this terminal is B. If we remove this resistor from the network, then terminal A and B becomes open. Now by shorting A and B, we supposed to find the current through that shorted path. That current is known as Norton's current or ISC. Now let us find ISC. IN is calculated as follows. I will draw the equivalent circuit. That is, there is 1 ohm resistor. Here we have 5 volt voltage source. This is 1 ohm. Here we have 2 ohm resistor. Then here we have 3 ohm resistor. Parallel to this, we have 2 amp current source. And this is the terminal A and this terminal is B. Now we supposed to remove this resistor. If we remove this resistor, A and B becomes open. We supposed to short this. The current through this is known as IN. Now let's find IN. So I will simplify this circuit further. Here we can see that 2 amp current source is parallel with 3 ohm. I will convert this current source into voltage source so that the simplification will become easy. That is, this is 1 ohm. I will keep it as it is. Here there is 2 ohm. Here we have 5 volt voltage source. The current through this is IN. So I will convert this current source into voltage source. That is, V is equal to I into R. That is 2 into 3, which is equal to 6 volt. Now the resistor 3 ohm is connected in series with this. In series with that, voltage source is connected with terminal plus minus, as head end of the arrow is up. The magnitude of this is 6 volt. This circuit is equivalent to this one. Now to find IN, we'll apply loop analysis and we can easily calculate this. Now let current through this branch is X, current through this branch is Y. So now I can say IN is equal to X plus Y. So let's find, calculate X and Y. By applying KVL to loop Y, first let's apply KVL to loop X. Apply KVL to loop X. I can write phi u is equal to 1 into x, so which is nothing but x is equal to phi u amp. Similarly, now I will apply KVL to loop Y. Apply KVL to loop Y. I can write 6 is equal to, these two are in series. That is, phi u y. So therefore, y is equal to 6 by 5, which is equal to 1.2 amps. So therefore, In is equal to 5 plus 1.2, that is In is equal to 6.2 amps. This is Norton's current or short circuit current. It is 6.2 amps. So now let's calculate Norton's resistance Rn. So this is a circuit. To find Norton's resistance, we supposed to remove this short circuited path. It should kept open. All the active sources should be made equal to zero. If there is a voltage source, it should be short circuited like this. And if there is a current source, it should be open circuited. I made it open here. So this is A terminal, this is B terminal. The equivalent resistance between these two terminals is nothing but Rn. So therefore, here we can observe that 2 ohm and 3 ohm are in series, which is in parallel with 1 ohm. Therefore, Rn is equal to 2 plus 3, which is in parallel with 1 ohm resistor. So therefore, it is 5 is parallel with 1. Therefore, Rn is equal to 5 divided by 5 plus 1, that is 5 by 6. Now let's draw the Norton's equivalent circuit. As I said, In is in parallel with Rn. Here we have the terminal A and B. Now to this terminal, in this circuit, we know current through 5 ohm we supposed to calculate, that is nothing but I. This 5 ohm, which is removed at the beginning, supposed to be connected to the equivalent circuit. Here we supposed to connect 5 ohm and we should find current through this. So this is Rn. The value of Rn is 5 by 6 and value of In is 6.2. It is 6.2 amps. So therefore, current I is equal to, by applying current division rule, that is total current into opposite resistor, that is 5 by 6 divided by sum of these two resistors, that is 5 plus 5 by 6. That is, simplifying this, I is equal to 6.2 into, this is nothing but 0.8333 divided by 5 plus 5 by 6 is 5.8333. Simplifying this, we'll get 0.886 amps. So this is current through 5 ohm resistor. Thank you for watching.